Hey everyone and welcome back to another Mining Chamber video. In today's video we are going to go over Team Red Miners step by step, and then I'll give you guys my opinion on it as well as the pricing and everything you need to know about using Team Red Miner in general. So now let's go ahead and get into it right after the intro. Team Red Miner is one of the most popular choices for AMD GPUs. Now, as you can tell by the name, Team Red Miner is made specifically for AMD GPUs, so you can't use it for Nvidia cards, and if you have Nvidia card, you can use a mix of two different softwares, so you can run Team Red Miner and T-Rex Miner at the same time. Now, at the time that I'm filming this video, Team Red Miner is at version 0.8.3, and you can use this guide for any version that they release, just make sure you always download the latest version. And any instructions that I go over here in this video, you will be able to use them in different operating systems. As you can see, it has built-in support for all these different operating systems, and you can just follow the same command line arguments the same way in those different OSs. So now let's go ahead and talk about the fee structure and how much Team Red Miner costs to run, as well as all the cryptocurrencies that they support. So as you can see here, there's a lot of different algorithms that this miner supports, and each one has their own different percentage. So if you look at the top, you have first your ETH on Polaris GPUs, so these are your RX 400 or 500 series, and the fees for that is only 0.75%, and that is for the ETH algorithm, so Ethereum and any other coin that's running on the ETH algorithm. And for all the other GPUs, it's only 1%, so it's also not so bad. Comparing to Phoenix Miner, which is only 0.70%, it's still not bad at all, but it does have some benefits to it, which I will be talking about later on. And if you're planning on mining Ravencoin, which is under the Kapow algorithm, then that will be 2% in fees, which is still not so bad. And then you have all these other algorithms. If you do find it here, then you know you can mine it and you can find the fee next to it. But generally for now, you only want to focus on these top two, because Ethereum is the most profitable to mine. And then once that goes proof of stake, then you can go ahead and take a look at the other options. Now I do have a video on Ethereum 2.0 coming out very soon, so make sure to subscribe so you don't miss that out. As for the GPUs that this miner supports, it supports almost all the AMDs, so whenever you see a new AMD card comes out, and it will show if it supports it or not. It might not be up to date with the 6000 series cards, and in that case, you can just run the miner, test it out, and if it doesn't work, you can always get in touch with them on their Discord. So that is a brief overview on Team Red Miner. I will give you guys my conclusion on it later on, whether you should be using it or not. So before we get there, I want to show you guys how to get a quick start on Team Red Miner to get started right away, and then we're also going to take a deep dive into the commands and show you guys the different commands and what you can use to help you mine better. But before we get into that, let's go ahead and have a quick word from this video's sponsor. This video is sponsored by Crypto.com. Crypto.com is an all-around platform for trading, staking, and storing your cryptocurrency. They also have Visa cards, which you can get by buying CRO tokens and holding it for some time. These cards are accepted anywhere that accepts Visa, and they also come with benefits based on which tier you get. But one of the best ways that I found as a miner to use Crypto.com is by utilizing their staking platform. You can use their staking platform to put your mining profits in there and then earn additional rewards on your mining profits. And it's super easy to get started with it. Simply mine to your Crypto.com wallet, and then from there you can stake as much as you want and earn interest. They have different staking options, and you can stake with a flexible plan, which means you can get your money out anytime, or you can do it contract-based, which earns you more percentage. So if you want to learn more and you want to see which options they have for staking, please feel free to use the link in the descriptions below and download their app, and then from there explore the options that you have. Now let's go ahead and get right back into the video. Now the first step for every mining software is to download it, and if you don't find your way around to the download section, all you have to do is just click on the releases. Now generally when you look up Team Red Miner download, you will be in the releases section anyways, so just click on that and then you will be seeing something like this. So now there's a couple of things that you want to do when you're downloading a mining software just for your own security, and that is to verify the checksums. Now instead of having to go over it through every video and show you guys how to verify the checksums, I decided to put it in the article for mining with Windows 10 on miningchamber.com. So all you need to do is just come to this article, which will be linked in the descriptions below, and then go to the mining software section. And then here you will find a write-up on mining software, as well as the different types of mining software. So you have the command line interface, as well as the graphical interface miners. So everything will be covered here in general, but mainly what you want is verifying the checksums. So if you scroll a little bit lower, you will find here the verifying checksums section. And then in there, you just want to go ahead and follow the instructions. Now, frankly, the instructions are made for Team Red Miner, so it will be easier to follow. But even if you're using a different mining software, it will be all the same idea. So just go ahead and follow that whenever you download the miner, and then you also want to do exclusions for your antivirus. So this is not required unless you're having troubles with downloading your mining software, but if you want to make an excluded folder like I did on my desktop folder, then you can go ahead and do that and then exclude that folder from your antivirus. So this is just a way to avoid from having your antivirus deleting your miner's folder. And the reason that you want to verify your checksums is to make sure that you have the authentic version of a TMRed miner or whatever mining software you're using. So I highly recommend going through these steps if you're downloading the mining software to make sure that you're on the safer side. So now back to TMRed miner, I will go ahead and download the zip folder from here, and then I will be saving it in my miner's folder on the desktop that's excluded from my antivirus. So now at this step is where you want to go ahead and verify your checksums, and if you want to do that like I mentioned, just go on the link in the descriptions below. So now let's go ahead and get into the quick start for TMRed miner and then talk about all the different files that are in here. So to get started with TMRed miner super quickly, all you have to do is just find the batch file that you want to use. So for example, if you're mining Ethereum, you want to go ahead and use start ETH. And if you're mining Ethereum with 4GB cards, you can use start ETH with 4GB. And then Ravencoin, you can just use Kapow. So it's all the same concept. And then MTP is for Fero and all these different coins that you can just find them all here. And if you want to dual mine Ethereum and Zelle, you can use this file. So you just get the idea. So whichever file you pick, for example, here, I want to use start Ethereum and just mine Ethereum with my 6800. I would just go ahead, right click on it and then do edit. So after you do edit, you will see this pops up. Just go ahead and click on more info and then run anyways. This is just because the TMRed miner is not verified publisher for Windows. So they always will give you these warnings, but it's completely fine to just skip them. So now once you open the file, you will see something like this. So up here you have your environmental variables, and then down here you'll have additional information that you want to use for your miner. So all this stuff right here is just commented out, so this will not be read by the software at all. Even if you delete all this, you'll be completely fine. And then you're just left off with this string right here. So here in this string, you see that there's a pool address as well as a wallet address. And all you have to do is just change those two and then run it. So for your wallet address, you can use your own wallet. And if you don't know which wallet you want to use, you can go back to miningchamber.com and then click on platforms right here. And after you go to platforms, you will find multiple different options for wallets. So there's two wallets here. You can just download any of them and then use the address that you want to mine to. So for example, since we're mining Ethereum, then you will be using your Ethereum wallet address. So now back to the batch file, you just want to go ahead and copy paste your address here. And after you change that address, you want to change the name of the worker as well, or you can keep it the same way. So this is just something for you to track your mining rigs. So in this case, I'm mining on my computer, so I would say my PC, or you can name it whatever you want, like I mentioned. So this is not important at all. And then you have your pool address. So for your pool address, you want to go ahead and select the right pool. Now for selecting a mining pool, you don't want to overcomplicate it. Just pick any pool and go with it. Honestly, the difference between all the pools is very small. Just make sure that you select the server that's closest to you. So I have a full video on pools if you want to learn more about the specifics. But for now, for the quick setup, all you have to do is just change the region based on your region. So since I'm in North America, all I have to do is just change the EU to US1. And then for the port, you can leave it the way it is and run it. If you have any issues with that, just add 1 before the 4s and then you'll be fine. So now I can go ahead and save this file, go back to the folder, and then just run this file. And now congratulations, you started mining. So you can see here, sometimes it will give you a warning. It says Crossfire Autolink is active. And then in that case, you just want to add this command. So go ahead and close the miner and then open up the file again, and then just edit that file and add the command at the end after X. So just after X, say dash dash enable and then compute. And then you can just save the file again and then run the file again. And then the first time you run it after adding enable compute, it might close right away on you, and that's fine. Just go ahead and run it again and it will be good to go. So now your computer slash mining rig is mining to that address on that mining pool. And whenever you want to stop mining, simply just close out the terminal. So now that is it for the TMRed miner quick start. Now we can go ahead and talk about the specifics and all the commands that you want to know when you're using TMRed miner. So the first thing that I like to do when it comes to a folder like this, I don't like it when it's messy like that. So I would just go ahead and click on the type right here. And then I would just take all the text documents and create a new folder and then just put them in there. So I will name the folder docs, and then I will take all the text documents in here and then move them to that docs folder. So now it's a little bit cleaner here, and all you have is just your batch files, which you need for mining. And I wouldn't move any of these files here unless you want to create shortcuts, which is completely fine. But just don't move them because they do rely on the position of the folder itself, because they are all calling back to the TMRed miner application. So now that we have all the docs in our folder, let's go ahead and go through the different documentations and then just talk about all these TXT documents so you know what they're for. So there's a lot of different functionality here, and we're not going to go through all of it because it will take very long time. But as you can see, if you just open up one of the documents, for example here O2 Lycos tuning, you open that up, you'll see here that it's just a quick pointers on how to tune for the algorithm that's used by Ergo. Now if you just read through it, you'll see here there's Polaris tuning and it'll tell you what you need to do for Polaris cards. It's a really nice documentation that gives you a really good idea of what you need to do for different algorithms. And then if you go down to dual Zell mining, you will see here it will give you some different information for Zell mining, which is also very useful, and here that's how you put in your addresses and everything like that. Now other than these, of course, you can also use the example batch files here, so it's a lot easier for you. So for example, if you're trying to use a 4GB card, you just edit that, and then from there you'll be able to see what different commands that they used. So here you can see for 4GB cards, they used ETH allocation epoch, and then they also used ETH4G max allocation. As well as one right here for restart GPUs, that is just mainly for doing the 4GB cards. So this is probably the best way you want to use this as a guide, is by going through these files and using the specific commands for them. Now if we go back to the docs, we can also see ETHASH tuning guide, which is nice for overclocking your GPUs for Ethereum mining. You can also go to miningchamber.com for overclocking, and then go to GPU mining and then GPU overview. So after you go here, you'll find different GPUs with their overclock settings. Just click on it and then you'll find the specific overclock settings for your card. So now back to the documentations again, you also have things such as map your GPUs, which helps you map whichever GPU is the one that's showing up in the terminal. And then finally, the most important thing you have is the usage. So the usage is what contains all the different commands that TeamRedMiner has. So here you find --algo or --a, which all stands for the same thing. So if you see two different ones like that, it's either you could do --algo or --a, and they're both going to serve the same function. So there's a lot of different commands in here, but we're only going to go through the ones that you want to know. So it won't take us long because the options that you want to know are very minimal. So what you need to know first is the algorithm one, of course, and that's when you want to change the crypto that you're mining. So here, for example, I'll go ahead and open up two different files. So you have the Kapow one, and then you also have the Ethereum one. So if you check the Kapow and Ethereum, you'll see here that they both have two different things that are running for the different algorithms. So you have -a Kapow, and then here you have -a ETHASH. So that will be how you specifically pick whatever algorithm you want to mine, and then place in the pool address and wallet address made for that algorithm and coin that you're trying to mine. So for example, if you're trying to mine another coin that's in the ETHASH algorithm, then all you have to do is just change your address for that coin and then find a pool that supports that coin that you're trying to mine, and then you're good to go. So that's for the algorithm command. Now other than the algorithm command, there's also the pools config option, which starts with -o. Now for this one is for your pool address, so you do -o and then you put the pool address. So it can either be stratum plus TCP or stratum plus SSL, which will be one for SSL links and one for TCP links. You can also add more than one pool by just doing -o again and then putting a -u and a -p. Now -u and -p means username and password. So generally the password is always X for all the pools. So you can see here -px. So you can always keep that as default X. Unless you make an account with the pool, then you want to go ahead and put your password. And as for your username right here, that will always be your wallet address. So it says -u, and then you put your wallet address and that will be your username. And then whatever you put after this period is going to be your worker. So this is the worker name, and you can even completely remove it and you'll be fine. So if you do decide to put more than one pool, you want to go ahead and do -o after the password and then just add a username and a password as well. And the benefits of that is if your first pool goes down or they have like server disconnection or anything like that, then it will kick off the second pool. So it's just like having a backup plan. Now if you also go a little bit lower, you'll see here there's some global pool options, and those generally run in the background so you don't need to touch anything at all. But these just will help you if your pool disconnects or anything like that, or you get a lot of rejected shares, then it will reset the pool connection and then run again. So you can feel free to change the default values with whichever way you want. Now if we go a little bit lower, here you have your GPU option. Now this is one of the important commands that you want to know. Now for the --devices or -d, this is for selecting whichever GPU you want to mine with. So if you have two GPUs in your PC and you're not mining on a mining rig where you want to utilize all the cards, then you can just do --devices, and then I would say for example 0, and it will only use the first GPU because the numbering here starts from 0. So it would start 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. And then you can just select your GPUs like that. And what you can also use this for is for mining two different algorithms. So instead of doing -a ethash, you can also do -a kapow, and then put number one for your devices and run two of these bat files. You'll have one mining Ethereum and then one card mining kapow. They also have a list devices command, which you can see all the GPUs that are triggered and the number that they're next to. And other than that, if you go a little bit lower, you'll see the fan control options, and these are just for controlling your fan. Honestly, I would just use these in the MSI Afterburner or whatever overclocking software that you're using. And then finally, you have the watchdog options. Now, the watchdog options is what monitors your miner and restarts it if it needs to restart, or turns it off when it reaches a certain temperature. So these are just security measures that are built in place. Now, you can go ahead and change the numbers as you want, but generally leaving it the way it is completely fine. And then after that, you'll just find the different ETH options and different algorithm specific options. So these, like I said, they're just better to go through them with the batch files. Now, that doesn't mean all this information is useless, but if you do want to read through them and just understand what everything does, then this is a good way to do so. Although there's one option that's pretty important here, and this is the ETH config. So as you can see here, it says that there's more information on this in the ethash-tuning-guide.txt. So let's go ahead and move on to that file right now. Now you can see here that this ethash config is also set automatically by the miner startup, and what that does is it finds the specific value for configuration for your GPU that works best for it. So this is great for Radeon 7s, RX 5700 XTs, and all the 5000 series cards. Now these modes do boost your hash rate, and they do help you use less power as well, which is great. So you don't really have to touch this command either, because it sets it up automatically, but it's just something that you want to know, because this is one benefit that TeamRedMiner has for the AMD cards. Now, if you keep scrolling down the usage.txt file, you'll just find algorithm specific options. So ProgPow, Kryptonite options, and just keeps going on and on. So all these commands I'm not going to go through, because honestly, you won't be using them as often at all. To mine Ethereum, all you have to do is the quick startup, but this is just things that you want to know in general when you're using TeamRedMiner. Now that covers the commands and all the documentation txt files. So now basically that is it for TeamRedMiner. If you guys have any questions, please let me know in the comments below. And if there's anything that I missed out, you can also let me know in the comments below. Now there is some advanced stuff that you can use with TeamRedMiner that also has to do with the API. So with these APIs, you can get information on your GPUs and use them with different applications that you want to use. But this is something I'm not going to be covering, but I will be doing a video on it in the future showing an example use case for this. So now as a conclusion, what do I think about TeamRedMiner? Honestly, it is my go-to for AMD cards. Now on HiveOS or Windows, I use TeamRedMiner, especially for my Radeon 7 rig. So with my Radeon 7s, I used to use PhoenixMiner for them, and then TeamRedMiner implemented that rig config that I was just talking about. Now once TeamRedMiner implemented that and then I used them, I went from 90 megahash to almost 100 megahash on the Radeon 7s. So using TeamRedMiner for the Radeon 7s definitely boosts your hash rate, so I would recommend it for that, as well as any AMD cards in general. So it's definitely a great mining software for AMD cards, and especially that it's made only for AMD cards, they can focus on tuning it down for those cards. Now same goes with TRX Miner, it's made only for Nvidia cards, so they're really good for Nvidia, and I will be making a guide on that next. So now that is it for the video. If you guys enjoyed this video, please leave a thumbs up, and if you're new here, make sure to subscribe. And thank you guys so much for being awesome, and I hope you have a wonderful day.